very, very strong political history for all political movements, but especially in Mexico with the TGP and the work of Jose Guadalupe Posada, and it's always been about art for the people, and that's why I love printmaking so much. And all of my art is inspired by all of you, which is the community of Oakland. And everything I've seen here growing up, this is a beautiful place, and I try to show that through my artwork. I do have a lot of skulls in it, but it's because I love skulls. They're very beautiful to me, symbolizes like a life well lived. But it is an honor to have my art up here in front of all of y'all, and to be on a wall next to Sochi. She's a living treasure of our community. She's decorated the walls of Fruitvale before I was born, and I just thank you very much. Happy Cinco.
I'm from Oakland, born in Berkeley, but raised in Oakland, so I play Oakland. I grew up in the Laurel District and also the Fruitvale District. And I remember walking around 1968. Yeah, I've been around a long time. We're in the 50s. I'm not shy to say how old I am. I'm 62, right? And I feel younger because I've had to, because I feel like I'm supposed to be here. I'm supposed to be here. I feel like growing up here, I was fortunate to have a father and mother that believed in me and my siblings. Say, hey, you know, you're Mexicano, you're Indios, you know, it's important that you be proud of who you are, your culture. We have a lot of history, a lot of craziness, but, you know, we're strong people. You know, we have the Pirámides, you know, we have people that are strong and have struggled. So we should be grateful for a lot of our ancestors and have struggled and fought and some lived and some died for us, you know. So when we think of Cinco de Mayo, I know I grew up in a time when Cinco de Mayo was ballet for political dancers and, you know, art shows and stuff, but it didn't really get into the political aspect of it. And then when you start reading more and more, digging out more stuff, because they only tell you so much, you know, but you start reading more and more, wow, is that what it really meant? And even today, looking at the laptop for the computer, the way not, it's almost like tracking people, you know, it's kind of scary. But at the same time, it's important because we're able to communicate with people all over the world, you know, in a short time. That's a big thing. But I remember my dad was an artist, and he came from Mexico. I had to kind of, before that hit to me, I got to talk a little bit about my dad, because if it hadn't been for him, I wouldn't be here. But even before that, I have a grandfather that came in the 1920s and he settled in West Oakland. And his parents got killed, and it was like after the revolution. And he came with a grandmother and a sister and brother. They settled in West Oakland. And he worked in the Southern Pacific Trains as he got older. And I'm not sure what exactly happened, but he stopped working there. He became a curandero. And so, if you can see some of my work, it does have a spiritual aspect to it, and also the indigenous. And some, you'll see sparks of political stuff that was going on at different times. This was 1991. So I have a lot of different pieces. I don't have all of them, because I have some work still from the 1970s, the 60s, 70s. I have a big storage full of stuff still I gotta take out. But my dad, he came as a young man, and he came in a hard way. Traveled around in the railroad in the train, and then settled in Oakland, and he always knew who he was. And so, like say in the 1970s, 60s and 70s, he since he was born in Mexico City, he knew who he was. And so he started teaching a lot of the young people about Mexico, because a lot of us didn't know all that yet. At least out in this community, Bluefield, and a lot of other people came. So there was almost like a renaissance, like in the 70s out here, you know? A lot of action going on, the Brown Berets, where it was happening, and what, the Raza Unida Party later on. So there was a lot of different movements, and also like the Clinicon and the Unity, the Spanish-speaking Unity Council. That was a Unity Council. This is a Spanish-speaking Unity Council, Spanish-speaking Citizens Foundation. So they're also changing some of the names, you know, cutting off words, you know. But they were all starting to come about, you know. And but it all had to do with the struggle of a lot of the people, because a lot of those didn't just happen. We had to fight. I was there. I mean, I wasn't one of the older people, but I was there helping or, you know, whatever I could do. So, you know, there's a lot of, the Vietnam War was going on, so there was a lot of stuff going on, you know. And, I'm glad that a lot of the young people are continuing a lot of those things, like protests and say, hey, we don't want no more of this BS. But, and I feel, I don't know why I was supposed to stick around here, because a lot of people, a lot of my friends, a lot of my family moved out of Oakland. And I even had somebody tell me one time, we're going to get a rope and drag you out of Oakland, you know, out of the community. I said, why? I'm not from here. Like, I love this place. So I just want to say thank you for continuing the struggle and you know, being aware of what's going on. It's really important that you be that. Talk to people. You talk to me and ask me about more of the 70s if you want. You know, and, thanks again. Yeah.